black box. And in that black box was?
The president.
In the corner of the world, there stood a little black box. And in that black box was?
The future.
In the corner of the world, there stood a little black box. And in that black box was?
In the corner of the world, there stood a little black box. And in that black box was?
You.
Me. Us. Our future, our past, our hope, our family,
our history,
our shame.
I'm sorry. I did my best.
The shame of a nation.
I'm sorry. I did my best.
The shame of a young mother's decision.
I know. You did your best.
The shame of not knowing.
In the corner of the world, there stood a little black box. And we did our best.
We did our best. Scene two, the present.
A young woman and a girl.
Vice. We follow the style of Jamaica Kincaid and girl.
Girl, come inside and wash your hands. I am making
the bread.
Okay, Mama. Scrub your fingers and get the dirt out of your fingernails.
I am scrubbing my fingers, Mama.
It's fingers, Miss Muffet. What would I do with you so
very, very quite contrary?
Don't chew with your mouth open. It's unladylike. Scrub behind your ears. You look so grubby after you've played out in the dirt all day. You look like a wild Indian with that hair all tangled.
I thought I told you to keep your braids. But you know I can't keep rubber bands in my slick Asian hair, Mama.
Well, you know better than that. I guess your hair is always going to be different than mine. But you are living with a white family now. So behave like a
good Christian girl.
Cross your legs, stand straight, and for goodness sake,
suck in your stomach.
Nobody wants to see your sway back in stomach.
But I am sucking in my stomach, Mama. I'm not tall.
Square-shouldered.
Aryan.
Ideal.
Like you and Dad and Brother.
I'm
short.
Curvy.
Thick.
Exotic. I stand out.
Bend over and brush your hair from the roots, or you won't get out all of the tangles like this.
No.
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 Not like that.
Not like that.
Not like that.
That.
Like this.
Like this.
Like this.
Harder.
Harder.
Give me the brush and I'll show you how hard you should be brushing.
Ow! Mama, you're pulling out my hair.
Okay, you are not scrubbing behind your ears like I told you to. Let me do it.
Ow! Mama, that's my skin. Those dark patches on my skin.
Oh no, I guess you are bleeding now. I'm not used to Asian skin.
I'm sorry.
I did my best I could. Are you picking at your scabs again? How many times do I have to tell you to keep your fingers off your face? And stop chewing your fingernails. Goodness, the neighbors will think I'm not feeding you if you keep chewing them down to nubs. And keep your fingers out of your nose.
Mama, pick them up!
Pick them up!
Pick them up!
It's pick me up. Say pick me up.
Pick me up!
Now sit still or you will have to get down off of my lap. This is how we braid our hair. This is how we tickle our ears, and this is how we hug till it hurts.
I love you, Mama.
I love you too, precious girl.
Do church steeple. Please do church steeple.
Okay. This is the church. This is the steeple. Open the door. and see all the people.
Do it again!
Okay, now you do it. Hold your hands like this. This is the church. This is the steeple. Open the doors and see all the people!
I like your hands, Mama. They're whiter than mine, with fine brown spots and wrinkly skin.
You should lotion your hands every day and put sunscreen on all of your skin, but especially your hands. It's too late for mine, but we show our age on our hands and necks.
These are Mama's arms, so strong and soft. Please put them around me.
They're just the right length to hold you close, sweet child.
This is Mama's nose, bigger and redder than mine.
And this is your nose, flatter, but beautiful and brown.
These are Mama's eyes, so big and blue and round. Not like mine.
But your eyes are beautiful, almond-shaped, and so black we can't even see the pupils.
Robbie at school says I have slant eyes.
Well, you need to tell Robbie that beauty is in the eye of the beholder. And I think you are beautiful, and God brought you to me to love.
These are Mama's lips, thinner than mine, and with lines around them.
That's for years of teaching children, and they will never be pretty and dark and full like yours.
One of the stupid boys at school said my lips are big like niggers.
You must never use that word.
Why, is it bad?
Yes, and that boy should never have used that word. Promise me you will never use that word again.
I promise, Mama. I hear Mama's heartbeat.
You must remember, sweet child, that is how we are alike. We may be different looking on the outside, but we all have the same rhythms inside our hearts.
Push, push, stab.
Wait, he was good.
I returned to that hibiscus tree and laid under her shade. But, like me, she did not look the same.
Push, push, stab. Push, push, stab.
Pain ripped through me, reminding me of him.
Push, push, stab. Push, push, stab.
I pushed and pushed and pushed, and the pain stabbed and stabbed and stabbed. Blood everywhere, from him, from me, from you.
Push, push, stab. Push, push, stab.
The petals of the hibiscus tree, wilted and dying, no longer fresh and beautiful, showered me like tears of shame.
Push, push, stab. Push, push, stab.
A voice cried out, your voice, from your tiny, perfect, hibiscus petal lips.
Push, push, stab. Push, push, stab.
I destroyed the hibiscus tree. I stabbed and slashed and slaughtered the branches she had witnessed, but did nothing to stop or to help. She couldn't or wouldn't. I left the knife, what was left of the hibiscus tree, and hid you in the black box. With a hibiscus blossom. And never return to the mountain.
Old woman, come forward.
Young woman, come forward.
And girl, come forward.
From this point on in our choreopoem, you three will be our players. Draw your characters from this black box.
Okay, sure. Where is it? Everyone gets one. Mm-hmm. All right. Yep. Yep. Give me that one. Okay, I've got it. This is it.
Okay, no looking.
Yep.
What? I said no looking.
We've already established
no. But Japanese.
Nope, guess again.
I know those Asian nail ladies in those salons.
Yeah, but Viet Cong or something. Seriously? Guess again.
Well, I don't know many other Asianises.
Korean.
Huh?
Korean! You know from Korea?
Oh, yeah. I heard about them.
Yeah, Korea. North or south?
Yeah.
Holy shit. Now, you seriously just asked that question. Read the news. No one from North Korea would be here.
Oh, asshole!
Well, where are you from? Racistville? Right off the turnpike from Redneck Town in Loser Junction.
Oh, I'm gonna kick your ass.
Yeah, you didn't seriously see that smart ass shit, did you? No, seriously, I want to know. Where are you from?
Chicago.
Yeah, born and raised. Chicago South Side. Where are you from?
I was born here, bitch. Unlike you.
Yeah, this is our land. Well, no one's really from here. So seriously, where are your ancestors from?
I don't know. England?
I guess. Well, top the morning to you. Good day, Governor Bob, your fucking uncle.
Okay. To the woman who I've never met and will never know, yet no better than anyone. You made me. You gave me life. You gave me up. And you made me. I do not envy the shame you must have felt and the horribly heartbreaking decision you made to give me a better life. I will never know your story, and yet I am your story. I will never know the whys or the hows. I will never know you, your face, your smell, the feel of your arms around me, your hands caressing my hair, your voice singing soothing songs to me and scolding me when I needed it. I will never know you, and yet I do know you. You are a part of me. You are the face I see in the mirror. Your shape frames the way my body is developing. Your voice comes out of my mouth. Your desires feed my heart and nourish my soul. How I envy other mothers and daughters who look like one another when they are out in public. I never looked like my adopted white mother. But she loved me, and she taught me the necessary skills to survive in this world. For example, when people who thought it was their business would come and ask my mother, "How long have you had her? Does she know she's different? Does she know she's adopted?" And my personal favorite, "What is she?" My mother would answer, "She's pretty darn smart and has great hearing and cognitive, so you can ask her herself." To which I would answer, "I'm Korean. What are you?" Rude. See, mother, I will never know. You don't have to worry. She gave me life skills. For example, when people who thought it was their business to fight off racist stereotypes, they didn't. Did you have boys who wouldn't date you because you were Asian, only to find boys who only dated you because you were Asian? Were you ashamed to think of yourself as Asian? I admit it, I was very ashamed. Sorry. I didn't want to associate with that part of me, which means I was denying you, my Asian roots, the past. Perhaps being teased on the playground became too much to bear, getting spit on, chanted at, or maybe I hated looking different, so different from everyone around me. My adopted mother said, "When I first arrived, I used to stare into everyone's faces for hours and hours. Until one day I said, 'Daryl has brown eyes just like me.' She realized I was trying to find someone, anyone, who even looked like me, even a little, in my sea of blue-eyed, blonde-haired family members. Dearest mother, I will never know. Did you have trouble fitting in? Were you ashamed because you didn't fit a certain size or race or gender? Did you not feel loved because you didn't look like your parents? Or you were a girl and they wanted a boy? Were you like me? Did you become a mother again? Were you able to keep that one? Or did you have to give that one up too? And if you did, was it more or less heartbreaking? Does it get easier? Does it get harder? Did you ever become a wife? Did you have friends? Were you a favorite daughter? Did you go to school? Did you see yourself as a shameful victim, like I often did? When the kids would chant at me and make fun of me for not having real parents. I do not want you to feel sorry for me, or worry because I was lucky. I had the strength of two mothers. One who bore me and gave me the chance at a better life. One who raised me and nourished me and encouraged the seeds of strength that were blossoming inside me, like the roots of a strong tree. Did you at least get to know what a true Asian model looked like? Did you actually feel Asian inside, and it matched how you looked on the outside? Mother, I did not have any Asian role models. Except maybe Connie Chung or an Olympic figure skater. We were never on TV, or white people would play us in the movies. And I was happy when I saw the first Asian model on the cover of a magazine. I was even happy to be compared to Margaret Cho. Even though we don't really look alike, there was someone at all to be compared to. Mother, I hope that you didn't have to worry that when you stepped into a room, that people assumed you could not speak the language. I still have people assume that I cannot speak English and are shocked when I open my mouth and I speak better English than they do. But I still have them say to me, "You live in America. Speak American." I grew up like the yellow dandelion amongst the white roses, where everyone else was white, 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 white. Or maybe black. Like a sick racist game of duck, duck, goose. But don't feel sorry for me, Mother, I will never know. For I know a secret they don't know. Being a dandelion is a good thing. Others may think of me as a weed, but we are the first food for the butterflies in the spring. Because no other flowers have bloomed yet. So you see, Mother, I will never know.
I am Wonder Friggin' Woman!
And your DNA runs through me. And I will pass that DNA on to my future children.
And together, our story will be told. Love,
your daughter.
Final scene. Old woman, young woman, and girl. Black box reprise. In the corner of the world, there stood a little black box. And in that black box was...
you.
Me.
Me.
You.
Me.
Us.
Our
future.
Our
past,
our
hope,
our
family,
our
history, our shame. We are the same woman with the same story.
Past.
Present. And
in the corner of the world, there stood a little black box. And in that black box was the future.
Thank you.